Hi, hello students, welcome to SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. Now we're going to see the course on geography. Kindly subscribe to our channel and also watch our playlist. Okay, my dear friends, see here we're going to deal about the topic called a latitude and longitude. Already in previous classes we had seen about a rotation and revolution of the earth. Kindly watch our playlist on geography so that you'll get all the topics, because here we are getting classes in Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English. So just better did not get much confused, my dear friend. Clearly I'll be dividing them in our playlist. Okay, keep supporting. We shall watch here. Oh, what is the difference between latitude and longitude? See here, friends, the horizontal line is called as a latitude, and it is also the equator. You know that it is a latitude, and also now north and south direction, it is a vertical line. A vertical line is called as longitude, and the main thing there is prime meridian. Why do these things are there? These both lines are imaginary lines. Why do we wanna imagine these lines and draw? It is because to locate a place on the earth, we need some certain coordinates to locate the region. For example, we shall locate a places based on the coordinates. Those coordinates cannot be provided naturally. So we created this imaginary lines so that now let me know. Okay, friend, I'll give you a challenge. Find the place where the prime meridian and also the equator, both the latitude and longitude, prime meridian and equator meet. Just mention in the comment section so that many others will know. You will also know, because I'm not gonna say that thing. Okay, now we shall move on, my dear friends. As usual, we're gonna start our class with a good motivational quote. Let's make it, my dear friend. Be patient. Empires are not built on it in a day. Remember one thing, my dear friend, the earth is such a beautiful, such a technologically upgraded. Now you are listening to my classes. Such a thing never came in a one day. The universe took 13.4 billion years to make such an universe, and also the earth took more than 4 to 5 billion years to build and become such thing now we, you and me, are living. So it is not a simple thing. An empire is not built on a day. It takes time, it takes lots of patience, it takes lots of hard work. Patience means just you go and sleep. That's not a patience, my dear friend. If you're gonna achieve something great, you're gonna build your own empire, you're gonna become something more than anybody can think, then you must work on it. Hard work, plan, systematic, everything procedural. You work smart, you work hard, everything, you just keep going. But the thing is that if you are working, just concentrate on your work, just be patient, because never expect anything somewhere else. Because if you're being patient, automatically everything will come your way. Just keep working smart and hard, my dear friends. Now we shall go to the topics. Here we're gonna see latitude and also now a longitude. Now what are all the topics that we're gonna see in these classes, and also we'll be explaining everything using the best images that will be helping you. Now latitude means it is the, what we'll be seeing about characteristics of latitude, and next a measurement of latitude, and next what are the important latitudinal lines, and next sample calculations of the latitudes that we will be knowing, and next we come to the longitude. In that we'll be seeing the characteristics of it, and also what is 0 degree meridian we'll be seeing, and also prime meridian, and next we shall see the measurements of the longitude. Okay, my dear friend, let's move on. See here, let me show you why we had found this lemon or orange. Okay, lemon only or no orange? Okay, I too got confused at school, my dear friend. See here, why is it if you slice it into half, what you can observe here? Yes, my dear friend, from the center the lines are passing like this. Okay, this is what happens to earth, how we take the earth in a latitudinal, how it happens from the center of the earth. This image provides you clear here from the center of the earth. See, as usual in an orange, how the slices are happening from the center of the earth. We take angles, which means the equator is taken as a 0 degrees, and also the line perpendicular to it to the north pole is taken as 90 degrees, and now the middle lines are subdivided. So those lines, okay, now you know what are latitudes. Latitudes are angular distances from the center of the earth to the equator and north pole. They are subdivisions. How many total subdivisions? Totally they are 180. So here now you can see how they are divided. See, this equator is there, other divisions are parallel to it. You can observe here, all the other lines are parallel to the equator. That is the thing you must remember in latitudes. Always latitudes are parallel to to equator, and also not always all the latitudes are of a same size. You can see here, why is it? It is the equator, and next this is the Tropic of Cancer, and again Arctic Circle. These are all the important latitudes you must be remembering. See here, Tropic of Cancer is 23.5 degrees north, and also 66.5 degrees north, and also 90 degrees north is the North Pole. And also here, same thing, Tropic of Capricorn is 23.5 degrees south, 66.5 degrees south is Antarctic Circle, and next comes the South Pole at 90 degrees. How does this degrees had came? The above image clearly provides you. From the center of the Earth, we are considering the angles. So from that, you had clear idea of what we are seeing. And next, one more thing, my dear friends, important thing. Here we can see what is difference between latitude and longitude. Latitudes are horizontal lines and also parallel to the equator. And next, one more thing, see here. Let me prove you how they are not of equal size. If you slice this into different pieces, now you can clearly understand how you are considering. This is what called as a latitudes, and here the different slices of latitude, different latitudes, if you cut into take, see here, equator is the largest latitude that we are having, and other latitudes are bit smaller than the equator comparatively. And next, here 1 degree of latitude is equal to how much? Approximately 70 miles and also 113 kilometers. So by this you can calculate the distance to the northern and southern hemisphere, which helps you. And now we shall see the theoretical concept here. Now you will be understanding much more clear whenever I am explaining. Latitudes are what? There's an imaginary lines, which means that are not unnaturally provided, but humans, we created them in imaginary way. And next, you take Earth. These are Earth's parallel to equator. See here, as I said, they are parallel to equator, so obviously we call them as parallels. And also characteristics, let us come to the characteristics of it. See, latitudes gradually decrease size from equator to the pole. As I said, my dear friend, you can see here, it's so cool to understand, my dear friends. It actually, when you are moving to poles, the size of the latitude is slowly decreasing. And next, one more thing here, degree of latitude is great at poles, and also that equator is, it is less. See here, these things only you can remember, degree, which means the degrees, as I had mentioned here, see here, the poles, the degree is higher, and also in equator, the degree is much more lesser. And next, the measurements, if you compare the angular distance, see, latitude means what? It is an angular distance measured from north to south pole from the equator. Yes, we take equator as a center, 0 degrees. From there we calculate to northern hemisphere 90 degrees, southern hemisphere 90 degrees. That is what we called as a latitude. And also distance between the latitudes are constants. Okay, my dear friend, distance between them is constant, not the total length. See here, total length means the circling the Earth, but a distance between each latitude is taken as equal. See here, you can see it is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and also each degree divisions are there. So distance between them are common. So that is the one I had said, 1 degree latitude is 70 miles or 113 degrees. This is constant, but the total length varies. And also here, 60 degrees latitude is half the length of equator. These statements you must be remembering. Certain exams, they ask as a statement. So to comparing to the equator, 60 degrees latitude is half. In the similar way, if you compare to the equator, the 75 degrees latitude is 1/4 of the equator. It is a basic thing, just a conceptual thing and also factual thing. And next we shall see what are the important lines in the latitude. As I said earlier, equator is 0 degrees. It is the largest of all latitudes, and it is a 0 degree latitude. Why it is 0 degree latitude? Here you can observe equator is 0 degrees, so you take it as 0 degrees latitude. And also Tropic of Cancer is 23.5 degrees north, Arctic Circle, and also Tropic of Capricorn, Antarctic Circle, everything I had clearly explained you. Next, sample circulation calculation, which means now each degree, you know what is the distance between each degree of the latitudes. Now you want to find the distance to the northern hemisphere. If it is 12 degrees to the north of equator, what will be the distance? So you multiply it. You know the multiplication, 12 into 11, see 111.03, but actually they would average it into 113. So nothing issues, my different, just average value you remember, 113. You multiply it, you get the value, that is 1332.5. But these things they don't ask, just remember. Okay, friends, now you know clearly what is latitude in clear. Now slowly we move on to the topic called longitude. Before moving, let me show you what is the difference between a latitude and longitude. Here, latitude I had explained, from center you are taking a half sliced one. Now, perpendicular to that, if you slice the earth and the same divisions you do, but here you do it in a 180 degrees. Okay, now you calculate 180 degrees angle and you draw a lines. So those lines are called as longitudes. See, the perpendicular lines to the equator is called as a longitude. So every longitude cuts the equator perpendicularly. Here the image is clearly shown to you how the variations is there to the latitude and longitude. And prime meridian, as equator you take as a main thing, or 0 degrees. In the same way, you take prime meridian as a main thing, as center, and also from there you take the distance, and also you make an angle and cut into different lines. Those are called as longitudes. See here, the latitudes are north and south divisions, and longitudes are east and west divisions. See, in latitude it is taken 90 degrees north and 90 degrees south. This is the division that is provided for the north pole and south pole in latitudes. And here in longitude it is taken as east and west, 180 degrees to the east, 180 degrees to the west. See here, all the points, which means the latitudes never coincide with each other, which means all are parallels. That is a latitude. But longitude, nothing is parallel, everything meet at a point called poles. So everything converge at one point. So this is the thing about differences, and you understanding whatever the thing you are required. Now you can see clear image of what is a longitude. See here, this is also slicing, but before you had took angles in this way. So now you are taking in a different way. So you are dividing from prime meridian. This is also taking from the center and finding the angular distance. This is also the imaginary lines. So you know how the longitude is drawn and how you take it away. So now the line of longitude is used to take time divisions, and also time divisions I'll be explaining in next class, because there is something special here. You consider this as a prime meridian, the main center, or the main longitude. Opposite to that, which means a next side, is called as international dateline. That topic I'll be making clear in next class. Also, now we shall see the difference. As I shown here, this is the prime meridian, this is the equator, and both are perpendicular to each other and also coincide perpendicularly. And next, the prime meridian is what which passes to Greenwich, England. It is an observatory present in England. From there, the prime meridian passes through it. From there, they calculate the time, 180 degrees to the east and also 180 degrees to the west. This 180 degrees they consider as a 12 hours, and this 180 degrees they consider as one more 12 hours. So total 12, 24 hours, 24 divisions you can remember. That is the way they used to divide. And next we can, so now you know, my dear friend, how, okay, when I'm saying time, I'll be explaining them in detail. Now you can see why this latitude and longitude, all the divisions. It is the divisions I said that we can find our location. So from the latitudes, we are dividing our earth into, see, from the equator we are dividing into northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. You can observe this northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere with latitude. And with longitude, you are dividing it into eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. So both hemisphere divisions are based on this latitude and longitude, and also it will be helping in your exams very well, and also in mapping, GPS, locations, travel. Everywhere you need a coordinates to locate a place and move to there, so that these latitudes and longitudes are much more important. Now let me explain you what is longitude. See here, it is a semicircular passing through the north south direction, and it is a north south direction means it every time cut the earth into half, which means all the longitudes are of equal length. Okay, all the longitudes are of equal length, all are known as meridians, and the important one is called as prime meridian. So all meridians are of equal length. So latitudes are not. Now longitudes, if you compare, all meridians are of equal length, and it extends up to 180 degrees to the east and 182 degrees to the west of prime meridian. I had said it earlier. And also all the prime meridians are meridians, exactly cut the equator right angle, which means a 90 degrees cut, and the degree of longitude is much more greater, which means 111.3 degrees, and also decreases gradually towards the pole. Okay, this is what you must be remembering. The degree we are taking, it is high at equator and also it is moving towards the pole, it decreases. And next, you can see here, my dear friend, the 0 degree meridian, which means prime meridian, it has been chosen during 1884 from there, from Greenwich place, from their observatory, they had chosen it. And also prime meridian divides the sphere into two hemisphere. Whatever the thing you had seen, eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere, it is a division based on a prime meridian. And next, all the things pass through Royal Astronomical Observatory in Greenwich in London. Now you know Royal Astronomical Observatory, that is the place where Greenwich we had taken this prime meridian. And also Greenwich meridian is adopted, why? It is to maintain a standard meridian, and also you'll be, while you are seeing the time, you'll be understanding it clear and much more importance of this prime meridian and longitudinal values. And next, the measurements, if you take longitudes or angular distances, as I had said earlier, they are moving between any point in the meridian to the prime meridian, they find the angles. Okay, next, and from prime meridian we are taking 0 degrees, 1 degrees, 2 degrees, and moving towards 180 degrees. So everything starts from the prime meridian. And next, longitudes are measured with east and west with the prime meridian, whatever the thing. And also one more thing you must remember, what are all positive longitudes and what are all negative longitudes? If such questions has been asked for you in your exams, the longitudes are counted west of prime meridian are called as positive longitudes. And also the meridians which are calculated to the east of prime meridian, they are called as negative longitudes. Let me show here, friends. You can see here, this prime meridian is taken here. Eastern side, all the meridians are taken as negative longitudes, and western side, all the longitudes are taken as positive longitudes. Okay, you had a clear idea of latitude and longitude. Okay, friends, this is SPV Educational. Together we create a better world. If you are not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe to our channel. And also, this is an education channel, one person, me, SP Rajan, taking for you from a rural background. So if you want to support me through crowdfunding to increase this channel to the next level and also help as many students I can, you can just crowdfund and also share with your friends, because this is Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English first ever channel in India to help the students. So it may take time to get our channel to be promoted, no issues. Just watch our playlist so that at least a few students get benefit with this playlist which I had created for your competitive exam. This is me, SP Rajan, signing off. Thanks for subscribing and supporting. I thank every subscriber, those who are supporting me. Bye, take care.